Alright, where do I begin? As is supposed to be with introductions. Right, hello, my name is Jack, one of the many engine drivers here on the Northwestern Railway. Generic, I know, but I feel like it's the best place to start. I drive Donald, the Scottish twin. Luckily, I do have a twin, Hunter. He drives Douglas. It just worked out that way. And also, we have friends we also work with. Doug, Oliver, and Arthur. I also work with Clay Dunes, a fireman, and also massive fan of Family Guy. And the guy named Louie, he is kind of obnoxious, but he is really fragile. I sometimes have to break Clay and Louie's fights, but anyway, we are a perfect combination.
Anyway, my mom got me this cool journal last Christmas, and I was probably going to draw in it. But I figured out a journal on detailing the railway's goings-on should be rather interesting. Anyway, the reason I really started writing this is because we're told this morning that in a few weeks, a solar eclipse should be coming to Sodor. Once in a lifetime occurrence! Aren't we lucky? But the big downside is we've been given extra night trains to deal with all the extra traffic. I suppose we can't do much. Oh, well, I'll update you as more comes out.
Alright, that since we've been having a day off, I guess we should have a conversation about the eclipse. So, Gordon, Henry, and James, what are you gonna do when the eclipse comes?
Well, since we've been thinking about the party, we might invite Rebecca, Emily, Molly, Murdoch, and Neville to watch an anime movie with us.
Yeah, just so we can have a lot of fun during the party.
Yeah, since we've been streamers online, we've been reacting to, like, everything.
Yeah, I've been thinking about that too, guys. Ugh, I hope you have a good time about that, Emily. I agree with Dunny. So, Bear, what are you gonna do?
Well, I was thinking of ordering some pizza for the party.
Something seems a wee bit off about this entire thing. They don't know when they could just sense it.
What could make you feel this way, Donald?
I don't know, Bear. I just have a bad feeling about it. Like, how nervous I've been about the sky turning dark and everything else.
It's just a solar eclipse, Donnie. Nothing to be worried about.
Yeah, I agree with Douglas. It's just like when the moon blocks the sun.
Aye, but you'll never seen the eclipse. Have you?
It might be true. They happen across the world a few times a year. It is also disgraceful, disgusting, and despicable. But wait. Maybe you've heard about something that was also really confusing for me.
What was confusing, Henry?
Well, Jack told me that he talked to Charlie Sand at Netflix the other day. He told me that my old friend Edward has been a little tense lately. Maybe Charlie Sand might have been, like, it might have been something from that research station in Kildare.
What research station are you talking about, babe?
Well, yeah, they used it as an old building, sweetheart, but it fits. But I don't think there's anything radioactive here.
Yeah, the last thing we need is a surgery in Chernobyl.
Well, thanks for reassuring me, Dougie. Anytime, brother. So, do you want to watch an anime show? I wonder what we should watch.
Quick update. The Fat Controller has confirmed a party on Valentine's Day. Well, the evening at least, since the eclipse is meant to come through around 8:31 p.m. That's a plan, at least. Not much I need to say. Works good. Yep, not gonna drag this on.
Okay, Boko's gone missing. Vanished without a trace!
Well, almost. We were taking a train to Upper Brandon and decided to shunt the train.
While we were doing so, we heard what I can only describe as a scream coming from the docks. We tried to venture further, but it was no good. The whole docks was closed off. Only after we returned, did we hear about Boko? No! We told the flight controller and he's been trying to contact the docks for hours! But I don't know. It's stressful. We've been sticking as close to Douglas as we can, but it's hard. The eclipse is coming really soon, but I'm not as excited as I was before. I'm not sure.
Good morning, Donnie. Good morning, Dougie. How'd you sleep?
I slept pretty well. What about you?
I kind of the same.
I haven't heard any update about Boko's disappearance.
Yeah. This is definitely going weird.
But hey, I'm still excited for the eclipse. What about you, Dougie?
Hey, I'm so excited for the eclipse, Donnie. I wonder where Jack and Hunter are.
I didn't know. Maybe they're late for our work again?
Hey, there's Jack. Where have you been, lad?
No. Just traffic. But I'm here now. Where are Clay and Louie?
Right here. You ready for the eclipse tonight?
I am a little anxious, but I'm mostly excited.
Good, because Hunter told me that Sir Topo Hat has a surprise waiting for us at the party.
Well, what do you think that could be?
Oh, no. Well, because half of the party is supposed to be around here.
Yeah, I heard it from the Bigger Sun Station Master. He said whatever it is will be good.
Well, count me as excited. Have a safe trip, Hunter.
And stay safe.
Thanks. You too.
All right, Dunny. I gotta go. Let's get my goods train in 1 hour. Well, mine is in 30 minutes. See you at the party, Donnie. See you at the party, Dougie.
Nice guy, isn't he?
Yeah, he does volunteer work at the local church sometimes.
Yeah, I guess they say it's kind of fun.
Hey, I hate to interrupt you two, but we have to take a goods train to Covid's Gate today. I don't care if you're ready or not.
Come on, let's just go already.
Oh, he gets on my nerves.
He gets on everyone's nerves, Clay.
Are we ready to go?
We're all good.
Great. Now let's head to Krovin's Gate for the eclipse.
One.
Oh boy, I'm looking forward to the party, sir. You really went all out.
Thank you, Toby. I've been planning it for ages. Valentine's Day friendship feeling for the whole island. There'll be a massive dance and banquet for when the eclipse begins. Spare no expense. I can just picture enough and filled food and dance accompanied by an unforgettable view.
Unforgettable sounds about right.
What do you mean by that?
Yes, Annie. You sound concerned.
Don't look up.
Sweet Henrietta!
Where did Sir Topham go?
Listen here, you blithering idiot! I've been working on it for months to prepare this!
Sir, my report said that the eclipse would occur in 4 hours.
Your report said that the eclipse would happen in 4 hours?
Sir, the time that it might come, it says at 12 p.m. I am having a bad feeling about this.
But what do you mean about 12 p.m.? The moon, it doesn't just speed up.
And according to the temperatures, you will be 70%.
70%?
And, sir, I don't know if this will be good. The eclipse might even cause a problem.
I just spent like 10 days preparing this. As they say, you're going to give me solitude in before I mark the kitchen as Mr. Jewelry's chocolate factory in which Percy will take a delivery. I've just seen so many bad feelings here from all of you guys.
He's really causing an approach.
Huh? Did the eclipse come early? What's happening to me? What the hell? Do it again! I wasn't looking!
Alright, so is everyone alright, Duke?
Yep, they're alright, Donald. How'd you survive?
Well, I was leaving the Little Western with the goods train, and I got all the way here, and I saw Reneas turn into a monster. And where have you been when the eclipse struck, Duke?
Well, apparently, I was sitting for repairs when the eclipse struck. It killed most of the workmen and changed a lot of them. The unaffected ones heard them out, but they only opened the doors because of the windows. Well, they shut the rest of the doors.
Alright. Yes, sounds good.
Oh, man. Oh, man, what is Dougie? Where's Dougie? Donald, what's wrong?
Oh, God. Dougie, I forgot. I gotta find Dougie. I think I need to go on a journey.
Well, calm down, Al. It's gonna be okay. Also gotta find my brother Bertram.
Huh. That's rather interesting. Hope you'll find them.
So I think we should spend the night here.
Alright.
Can't believe everything had gone to shit here. Seems like everyone is asleep except me. Maybe I should go outside for a smoke break.
Well, these people gotta be lying. Like, I can't believe those idiots are afraid of cute Charles. First, they are once shut up about how excited they are for the Eclipse. Then, it gets here and it barricaded us in the works. And it kept crying about how Clay fell on the train. Maybe if they weren't staring at the moon, this wouldn't have happened. I mean, what I saw was crazy. But no monster could find me here. Alright, good morning everyone. Got a big day ahead of us.
Wait, have you seen Louie?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know, Donald?
Last night I saw him walk out of the entrance.
Yeah, he just walked up to us and he asked us if they'll be alright here if he go outside for a smoke break. I was about to check on him for a few minutes, but looks like he went missing.
What? Doesn't sound good.
I hope he's alright.
So, any one of you want to be my fireman?
I'll do it.
You sure?
Honestly, yes. I want to help.
Huh. We gotta load up. Alright. Duke, you head up the mountains to see if there are any survivors on the narrow gauge railway. Jack, you, Coco, and Donald will go on an adventure and find Douglas and Hunter. If not, you can come back here. Any questions?
Are you going to deal with those monsters?
Coco? Who is he?
He showed up in the middle of the night, Jack. He said that he had been attacked by a monster while he was walking through a nearby town. He was about to stun the creature by using his camera and flat hair.
Light scary things? Good. I have extra lamps for Donald.
And I have extra lamps for Duke. Alright, Donald. Good luck. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Well, here we go.
Don't worry, Dougie. I'm coming for you.
Oh my God! Emily! No! I promise, my dear sister, the times that me, Dougie, hang out with you, and ye and Henry will make the times will never be forgotten.
Goods straight on the path?
Maybe I should sneak past. The hope someone is alive in there. I mean, looks like...
Wait! Is that Murdoch?
Poor Murdoch. I should hope this damn eclipse didn't affect Dougie. Can you believe Emily and Murdoch are dead? Maybe I should go check out Kilday. Wait, what's that I see?
Toby? Jeep?
Donald! You're alive!
Yeah, I'm so glad to-
Oh! Ow! Oh! Ow! Oh! Oh, my fucking sword! Oh, fuck!
But what the- Jeep, what's going on? Oh, fuck.
I'm getting out of here!
Oh my God! Oh my God! You're really gonna get a heart attack!
You're an attacking Kudo! We're alright, Donald!
Yeah! Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm so terrified.
There's a bunch of blood on me. And even a bullet who ran through my cab window. Oh, James. He died instantly, right in front of me.
Rest in peace, James. You will be remembered.
Oh man, at least I'm cleaned up. Oh Bailey, how'd you survive?
Well, you see, I was working here in the station by the Tribune when the eclipse struck. I didn't pay much notice, but are you okay?
I am. I'm just really worried about Dougie and my little quacker of Dilly. I just really wanted to find them.
Well, don't worry. I'll be joining your expedition.
Ugh. Thank you, old Bailey. Alright, we should probably check in the ironworks. It doesn't die! Ugh. Seems like Weef is dead. Maybe I should keep going all the way to the ironworks. Alright, now all the ironworks. See if anyone is there. Oh my god! Well, looks like Diesel 10 is dead, but who could cause this kind of damage? I hope Eddie and Bert are alright. Maybe I should go find them. Nanny? Looks like Eddie and Bert are dead. Maybe I should take the smelter shot. I do hope anyone's in there. Oh, yes. Now that is what I'm looking for. A nice warm place instead of being out in the cold? Oh, this is really nice.
Oh! Hey, what's up, dude?
Hello, Mr. Donald. Nice to see you. Hey, everyone! We got a visitor!
Wait, what? Oh, wow! Got a bunch of people here.
Oliver! Donald! What's up? Oliver, I'm so glad to see you!
I'm glad to see you too, Donald! So, what do you think of it? A slumber party here?
Oh yeah! Definitely a big hit for the solar eclipse!
So, you know what I say? The odd one is safe as haven! You can say that, dude!
Yeah, but still had a broken buffer in the rivers.
So, are you ready to set up camp?
Alright, Oliver! Let's do it!
So, Oliver, what happened to you in tow during the eclipse? It's a long story, Donald. You see, me and Todd were taking a goods train from Nafford Harbor. I hadn't paid much attention to the eclipse, because me, Grace, and Pearl are pretty damn good at our job. But however, as I was waiting at Lower Tidmouth, I saw Henry shoot past, something that took control of the big green engine. Well, I couldn't hear him screaming or crying. I couldn't even describe it. Well, and as I passed him a shed, I also heard an engine screaming and crying. I couldn't tell who it was, but it sounds like my bestie Duck. Well, I didn't stop until I got to Ellsbridge, and I stayed there for a few hours. And later on, I arrived at Wellsworth to pick up a bunch of workmen for Brenham as possible. However, we have planned to, well, as we passed up a Brendam, we were stopped because something big was blocking the path. I could still see a little bit in the docks. Cranky had clearly fallen over, and there seemed to be a fire at the Shipping Co. building. But there was an enormous group I have collected. But however, I saw, as I passed Trevor's shed, it looks pretty empty. And as I headed back to Wellsworth, I saw Toby's shoot pass headed with Annie, Clarabelle, and Henrietta. However, I haven't seen them since. But it looks like they're heading to Kronk.
That really was quite an adventure, Oliver.
Yeah, it sure is, Donald. But, haven't you seen any other engines lately?
Well, I did see a few of them, but some had died. As I was passing through Krobin's Gate, I saw Reneas, but he got mutated into a monster.
And I hid at Krobin's Gate Works after I saw Reneas. I saw Duke in the works, and that's when we met Coco. Duke is already heading down the line to see if anyone else is there.
And as I passed Kelsort Road along the main line, I saw Emily and Murdoch, but they're both infected and dead. And as I arrived at Kildane, I saw Thomas and James, but James had exploded, causing Thomas to run away in fright.
And also found Addy, Bert, and Diesel 10, but they're already gutted.
Oh yeah, when I arrived at the Ironworks for shelter, I found Ari, Bert, and Diesel 10 unharmed. They told me that they were shunting and loading some trucks when the eclipse occurred, and when they saw people get infected. Me and Toad told them about our experiences until Boko came in. He was infected and turned into a monster. Toad screamed in horror, so Diesel 10 ordered us to get into the smelter shed and shut the door and it'll hold it off. Diesel 10 tried to fight the thing, but it eventually grabbed the claw and jammed it into the middle of his face. Yet, he fails. And the thing eventually killed Ari and Bert as well.
And yeah, it was definitely rough. Was it, Donald?
Hey, it sure was, Oliver. I'm trying to look for Dougie and Hunter, but me and Jack has got to find them somewhere.
Well, don't worry, Donald. I'm here to help you.
Oh, thanks, Oliver. That means a lot.
Anytime, Donald. Because we gotta protect this anime verse.
Hey, because there have been some of my friends that I met before who have left here. And I think we should head out tonight. Because I literally need to go back out there and fight the...
Whoa! Not so fast, Donald. We definitely need to stay here tonight.
Really? What for?
Well, from my experience, I heard that those monsters are far more dangerous during the night. With the lack of light, they're about to get stronger.
Huh? Oh, you're right, Oliver. You're right. I guess we'll have to spend the winter night here in this warm room.
Yep, I knew I was right the whole time.
Same here, Mr. Oliver.
So, how's the pizza, lads?
So good out there, Donald. Yeah, definitely had a delicious food out there. Well, I'm really happy that you have dinner there.
Hey, Deck and I think that my firebox could be a stove.
Oh, hey, wait a second, Oliver. I think I forgot something.
Donald, what did you forget?
Oh, I think it was my little duckling Dilly. I always sing about her and how sweet it was, and you wonder where she is or how she hasn't died yet.
That sounds nice.
Jack, what are you doing in there?
Oh, Cookie gave me a little flower.
Oh, how sweet.
Sorry about that, Donald. Didn't want to bad mouth the dead.
But yeah, holy fucking shit. You're so much better than Clay.
Yeah, Jack and I agreed to be Valentines for one another.
Yeah, so I guess it's a little bit of light on this entire situation.
Aw, happy Valentine's Day, Jack and Coco.
I know. Sounds romantic, Donald. I couldn't believe that you have your special friend with you.
Hey,
ever since they first met at Crawford's Gate. Hey, wait a minute. Seems like everyone's gone to bed.
I think I should get some sleep too.
Alright. Oyasumi, Oliver. Oyasumi, Donald.
What's all that noise coming from outside?
I don't know, Donald. I don't know what could that be.
Maybe someone is trying to get in, or I don't know.
What a relief! I thought we could have died.
Same here, Donald.
Oh man. Jack, can I sleep?
Me neither, Donald. I am really missing Hunter. I am also really missing Dougie. Although Hunter is with Dougie, but he isn't my brother that I should have left behind. I know it's really stressful. I'm working on my journal entries and yeah, I've been enjoying that too.
Same.
Although I have stopped writing about jokes.
I guess you'll try to be funnier.
Yeah, I guess.
Ugh. Morning already?
Oh, what the hell?
Oh man, I feel like shit.
Well, good morning everyone.
Well, good morning Oliver. How did you sleep, young lad?
I slept okay, but despite that banging on the door last night, what about you?
Ugh, no. I didn't sleep at all. Although I fell asleep 3 hours later, but banging on the door kept me and Jack up last night. I'm so tired and grumpy. And I feel a little dizzy on the inside.
I know. I guess last night will probably give us nightmares.
I could probably feel real at times.
Yeah, I get what you're feeling, Donald. I know you're missing Douglas, and I am definitely missing my young hero, too.
I know he saved you from scrap all those years ago, as well as Isabel, Dulcie, and Toad, but what are the other cultists?
I don't know, but I just dropped him off at Tidmouth Holt. I just hope they're not dead.
If they are, no luck for us.
Well, it's already 7:41. So I think I have a plan, Donald. You go head down to Kildade to see if anyone else is there, and I'll meet you at Woolsworth.
All right, Oliver. Let's get moving. Alright, should be traveling back to Kildade to see if anyone else is there. Old James is dead right there. But I know I'll meet back up with Oliver Wellsworth. Wait, is that another rancher next to James? Gordon? Are you alright, lad?
James, why did you have to go?
I know you had something upset about James Bond. Just so you know, I think I saw his boiler explode yesterday. Rest in peace, James. You will be remembered.
Donald? Are you okay? You seem a little worried.
I really am worried, Gwen. I am really worried about Dougie and Dilly. I just really wanted to find my brother, my little Quaker.
Oh, I'm sorry about that, Donald. Well, I'll be joining your adventure. So, where are we gonna go?
We're gonna meet with Oliver at Wellsworth. He's probably gonna find survivors there.
Oh, I see.
So, Donald, did you find anyone?
Yes I did, Oliver. I found Gordon and killed Dave. He was sitting through deep scoops like a psychopath. He's also worried about Rebecca. And, where is Todd?
I shot into the goods train there. He's alright there.
Oh, that's good. Find anyone?
Yep, I did. I found Molly and Neville here.
So, Neville, what happened to you during the eclipse?
Well, it's kind of a short story, Donald. Well, you see, I was taking a goods train to Vickerstown to get ready for the party. However, after I left Knapford Harbor, after Henry left, when the eclipse came, I saw people getting infected right near the road. And to risk not any chances of death, I pick up the pace to Wellsworth. And I passed by Castle on the way. However, that was cut short from the brakes and the sound of crashing and screaming. Then, Molly found me here, and we decided to stay here at Wellsworth until you guys came here. Well, we got some bad news for you two. Well, Donald is trying to go down the main line. Emily and Murdoch are dead at Kelso Road and along the main line. Well, rest in peace to my best friend. You're in a better place now, Murdoch.
Yeah, I agree with Neville. And as you see what happened to me, I was picking up passengers near Hoenn Lake at the Peel Harbor branch line when the eclipse struck. And I saw people screaming and getting infected, except for old Bailey. Not to risk any chances, I departed faster than I've ever did before, and I passed Whiff along the way, and I got switched along to the main line all the way to Wellsworth, and that's where I found Neville.
That was interesting, Molly and Neville.
Yeah, sure is.
Yeah, but I could assume Whiff is dead.
Oh yeah, I did find him dead while I was trying to find Oliver.
I knew it the whole time.
Oh, yeah. As I was shunting my goods train and helping Toad, I think I saw some mail vans. I think those might have been Percy's mail vans.
And something about Toby and Tommy's. I hope they're both alright. Maybe they made it to the mainland, I guess.
Oh, yeah. I definitely doubt that, Oliver.
What do you mean by that, Gordon?
Well, I've last heard that Vickerstown drawing bridge has been ripped apart, just so that no infected people or engines get to the mainland.
Well, that sucked.
Oh, Dougie. Oh, my brother Dougie.
Please pray to God that you're alright and still alive. I hope you're okay. I'm teaming up with some engines to help me find you. This is Donnie. I'll see you soon.
Hey, Donald. It's gonna be okay. We'll try and do everything we can to find Douglas. Let's just stay here for the night and come up with a plan tomorrow.
Oh man. I've been hiding in Henry's tunnel for like 3 days now. I do hope some of my other friends are alright, and even my partner Gordon, but I do feel really bad for Henry already. But I just hope Croven, Dudley, Eagle, and Bruce are alright. And even Timothy. Because I was supposed to meet them there when the Eclipse arrives. Wait, what the hell? Is that Albert? Holy mother of LNER! Poor Albert. I hope he's alright. Maybe I should get some sleep until somebody finds me here.
Alright, Gordon. So, I think I have a plan. So we're going to head down the main line all the way to Nefer to see if anyone else is there. I'll be right in front to see if anyone is there. And you'll be a traveling light engine in case if we're attacked.
That's what I've been thinking about.
Yeah, definitely. But, Oliver, stay here.
Alright, good luck. And hope you two don't die.
Hey, we won't.
Yeah, we'll never.
Ugh. Seems like Henry's spot is just frozen.
Yeah. Can only imagine that, dog. Like, how frozen it is? Like, with so many icicles. But at least we have our warm fireboxes to keep Beep Jack and Coco warm. And even Keith and Stefan.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying that too. Since Eclipse had started.
Yeah. I've been thinking about it too.
Yeah. I knew I had a bad feeling the whole time, like, when everything turned into chaos days ago.
Yeah, I could have the same feeling too.
Yeah, I guess we'll...
Oh, Gordon?
Donald, what's wrong?
I think I see Poco, but he looks like a monster. Close again.
Gordon! What were you thinking? Leaving me alone there when I was in danger? You could have let me to die!
Donald, calm down! Maybe something's wrong with him. If it wasn't for Henry, we'd be dead!
What do you mean, you two?
I'm sorry, Donald!
Gordon, I didn't mean to shout at you. I was really scared. That's all. Maybe we should head to Crosby and calm ourselves down.
Oh man, you all right, Dick?
I'm all right, Donald. I'm still writing my journal.
Oh, okay. I guess we could do that while we wait.
James, why did you have to go? And Henry, what happened to you? My life is in danger. My best friends are probably gone.
Jack? You're done?
Yes I am, Donald. Let's continue on our journey. Alright.
Oh, Gordon. Boy, that must have scared me really good.
Yeah, it scared me really good too. But, yeah, I heard that Poco turned into a monster. But how?
I don't know.
there is a lot of hidden mysteries here on this island.
Oh, whoa! What the hell? Looks like a mess here in the yard.
Yeah, seems like Tidmouth Station is not so lucky.
Aye, but I do hope anyone is in there. Wait, is that Arthur? Poor Arthur. Can I believe we lost one of the little Westerners?
At least he's in a better place now, Donald.
Well, looks like we failed to search a Tidmouth Station one. Now it looks like we need to look at Timmy's sets now.
Yeah, I guess we can do that.
All right, Don. Looks like you're a pro to Timmy's sets of point.
What's that I see?
Edward? Harvey?
Donald? Gordon?
How on earth did you two survive?
Well, Donald, you see, I was at the harbor when the eclipse occurred. It didn't take much notice of it, but some workmen did, and it killed them instantly. And I didn't stop till I got all the way here.
Yeah, and I was at Napford Station when the eclipse struck. And I ran to Timmy's sheds, and that's where I met Edward.
But, by the way, have you seen James and Henry?
Edward, I hate to say this, but James died in a boiler explosion and Henry is probably a runaway.
Oh no, James, Henry, why did you two have to go?
I know you're sad and upset, Edward, but I am feeling the same way. And by the way, Donald Gwynn, there was also another engine in the shed. We were lifting trucks off the turntable.
What? Another engine? Hold on. We'll go check it out. All right. Let's see who's in there. Holy shit.
Hello, Donald.
God, don't. You look terrible.
I know that.
But despite that, I'm glad you're okay.
Glad you're alright too, Doc. Come on, let's get you out of the shed.
Hello, Gordon.
God damn, Doc! How'd you get infected?
I don't want to talk about it right now.
I understand, Doc. You don't have to tell me.
Alright, lads, so next part of our plan. We should probably stay here for 1 hour before you head to Netherd and find someone there.
Sounds like a good plan, Donald.
Oh god, James, Henry, why'd you two have to go?
Was it just me, or did I hear Gordon mumbling to himself?
Alright, lads. Should be at the harbor any moment. Looks like the city is frozen, but still in good shape. Alright, here we are. Is everyone good?
Yeah, I'm good.
Yep, doing alright.
Yeah, we're doing fine.
Oh god, no. Get out of my head. James, Henry, Boko. Why'd you have to die and get infected? And Rebecca, where are you? Oh, for goodness sake, good.
Shut the fuck up! What did you say?
Alright, I said, would you stop being an idiot about your friends? Isn't that close to you? And even your girlfriend?
Why are you little?
I'm surrounded by idiots!
Donald, you seem a little angry.
Yes, I am, Edward! I'm so angry because Gordon and Duke are still fine! See?
Duke
call me a fucking galloping sausage, you great western bitch!
Don't call me a great western bitch, you stupid!
Don't you dare call me stupid!
Alright, that's it!
What do you want, Donald?
Oh, what is Dougie?
Keep your Scottish nose up, Donald! Nothing to do with you!
Oh, shit! You kidding about Henry G? Go out, Rebecca! You idiot! This fucking useless thing!
You idiot, Donald!
Shut up, Duck! You just a great fucking bastard! You know that? You just did fuck up!
Oh, now I'm Rebecca!
No, you're Rebecca!
No, you're Rebecca!
No, you're Rebecca!
No, you're Rebecca! No, you're Rebecca!
No, you're Rebecca!
Shut the fuck up!
No! What the hell? Edward, what's your problem, man?
Sorry, Donald. I just don't know what got over me.
Alright. Gordon and Duck, is there something you two should say to each other?
Yes, we do, Donald. Duck, I am really sorry for shouting at you.
And I'm also really sorry for making a comment and snapping at you, too. Do we forgive each other?
Of course, Doc. Agents always forgive each other when you argue. Especially when Donald and Douglas argue. But, however, we're still apart.
Yeah, I hope we'll find him.
Yeah, I agree with you too. We agents, if we are adventurers, must stick together.
Yeah, definitely got the point, Harvey. Alright, we should probably set up camp here.
Alright, Donald. Sounds like a good plan. Okay, everyone. We must keep each other together and keep an eye out for any monsters if we want to live. All right, Timothy. Sounds like a good plan. Me and Croven will be your bodyguard. Yeah, I agree with Ashton. Let's just all stay together so we do not get killed.
You can say that, you three.
Yeah, I agree with Eagle. Let's just hope we don't get killed. And I do hope Bear and Donald are all right.
Well, I'm about to head out and evacuate more people on the island, and I hope I can find James.
Alright. Good luck, soldier. Thank you very much, Dudley. Well, to lighten the mood, Timothy, I hope your brother Thomas is okay. Oh, right, Thomas. Well, I do hope he's alright. Yeah, if not, then I guess we'll go find him.
Ugh, oh boy. Boy, it's such a good camp here.
Yeah, definitely, Donald.
Yeah, I agree. But it seems like since you're becoming an adventurer, we were trying to think of giving you and Douglas a new blue paint scheme. It seems like Duck and Harvey are sleeping.
Yeah, so we're the only ones awake. So I guess we're having a fun time here at the camp, and what else could possibly go wrong? Wait a second, is that Leonard?
I think it is, Gordon. What is he doing here? Hold on, lads. I'm gonna go check to see where Leonard is going. Seems like he's heading to Leopard.
Alright, well, be careful out there.
Leonard, why didn't you stop, lad?
Well, I was going to pick up Rickety from Nafford Harbor, Donald. So that's why I stopped here after I saw you, Gordon, Edward, Duck, and Harvey at the sheds. And I found some workmen at the yards, and then they climbed aboard on the buffet coach.
Well, at least they're alive. Well, yeah, but we're not the only ones alone. There is also another engine right beside us.
Hey guys, what's up?
Patty! You're alive!
I know, Donald. But I'm not feeling so well. How come? I don't know, Leonard. Something is wrong with my boiler, but I'll tell you about what happened when the eclipse struck. I was pulling a local at the back. As I was waiting for the passengers to board at Lower Napford, my driver and fireman are having a conversation a little about what they should do when the eclipse comes. However, after the eclipse came, I saw people getting infected near the platform. My driver quickly reversed me back, and I almost forgot that I left my passengers at the station. And I raced back to Napford, and I took shelter, and I didn't come out. However, yeah, I also heard Henry and Albert's whistle, and I also heard them screaming in pain.
Oh, I see.
So, Barry, what is your crew?
They're searching for supplies in the transit hub. And once they come back, they're going to refill me on coal and water.
Alright, well that's good.
Wait, hold on, lads. I think I hear something behind us.
Really, Don? Could you get a good look at them?
I don't know, but I think I see a big green diesel. Probably Boko or Bear.
It's gonna blow!
Sorry, Donald! I can't stay anymore! I think I'm gonna stop you! Water, dodge a deal! Bye!
Oh, all right, Golden Edward. I'm back. But I got some bad news!
What's the bad news, Donald?
Yeah, you seem a little scared.
Oh, okay, well, I found Leonard. He was picked up Rickety and Neffert Harbor, and I saw Barry. And I think I saw some Red Express coaches in the platform, and the thing eventually kidnapped Rickety, and Barry was blown up.
Oh, damn!
Well, that's not good.
Hey, seems like he suffered the same fate James did.
Yeah. Rest in peace, Barry.
Hey, guys, I got some good news and bad news.
What is it?
Well, I got a call from Duke Strabber saying that he successfully picked up Sir Handel, and they also found Peter Sam at the Slate Quarry. However, Peter Sam was telling his story. He was with Scarlowe when the eclipse occurred, but he died by falling into the water when the rock slide occurred. And we also got a call from a signalman at Allsburg, far further into the Little Western. He said that he found a fish train down in the water, and he claimed to see a purple shape right in front. He claimed that he saw Ryan, that he drowned while trying to escape.
Well, lost another Little Westerner. Can you believe it?
Well, at least Arthur and Ryan are in a better place.
I know. Well, he is also a good engine.
Well, ever since the GNR, I used to work there. I think we should get some sleep. It's probably getting late.
It should is one. All right, oyasumi, lads.
Oyasumi, Donald.
Or also me, Donald.
16? Where are we going?
We need to get off of this island now!
Now the only way to get off of this island quicker is taking a shortcut through the Great Waterton branch line to get to Freaking Side of the Bridge as soon as possible to get out of here, or else we'll be affected by the eclipse, Wilbert!
I hope you're right, 16. Let's just hope that we get out of this hellhole and try and save the others.
relying on us ever since we left the harbor. 16? Are you right there? 16? Oh my god! 16!
Rebecca, take care of her for me and tell her I miss her very much. Gordon! No! No! Don't worry, Jack! I'll be coming here soon! Drilled.
Well, you got some voice in your head, Gordon, and it kept tormenting you, and you eventually couldn't take it anymore, and you tried to kill yourself by ramming into those flat beds of pipes. Harvey tried to stop you, and you eventually killed him. And that's where we're at now.
Why did I have to kill you, Harvey? But you definitely saved my life.
He's definitely a brave Crave Engine. Rest in peace to him.
I know. Can somebody get me back on the rails?
I'll get Able Gun. I'll be back.
Alright, guys. What do we do?
Well, me and Donald got a plan. We should probably head back to Wellsworth to meet up with Oliver, Molly, and Neville. So, are you guys with me?
Hey, I'm with you. But I'm a little scared. Because I'm a little afraid that Boko might kill me.
Yeah, I have a bad feeling too.
I may not be a smart blue engine, but I know what roadkill is.
There must be a safe way. Okay, here's our chance. Ready, set, go!
Boy, Gordon, you were like insane this morning.
Yeah, I know that, Edward, but what was that damn red lumpy thing?
I don't know. I think I feel it in me too.
We're going slow on the way.
Whoa, 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 stop!
Wait, that? The thing?
Oh, crap. He's back!
Oh, shit.
Run for it!
Okay! Oh no! Come on! Come on!
Yeah!
Philip! We did it!
We did it! Oh, yeah!
All right, Golden! We lost it!
Oh, man. Is everyone okay?
Oh, I am, Gold, but I thought I was gonna die.
I thought I was gonna die too, Donald. Yeah, I am too old to die.
But hey, at least I saved your lives.
You definitely did, Gordon.
Yeah, all right.
Well, so what should we do now, guys?
Well, Gordon, I was thinking that we should travel back to Walesworth to meet back up with Oliver, Neville, and Molly. Hopefully they find more survivors there at that camp.
Well, I was thinking about that too, Donald.
Hey, Gordon, there was one question I need to ask you. What happened to you during the eclipse?
Huh. I don't remember, Edward. But I remember passing by Mer, who was heading towards Brandon Docks from Britain. That was the last time I saw him.
Huh. Very strange. Alright, lads. You ready to go?
I am ready to go.
Ready to go.
Ready to go. Alright. Let's go to Walesworth. Edward! You coming?
Oh, I'm coming.
Alright, lads. Just a few minutes to Walesworth, which is where we meet back up with Oliver, Molly, and Neville.
Yeah, we're nearly there, man.
Nice to see you three again.
Hey, Donald, what's up? Look who we found.
Whoa! Toby? Thomas? Sar? Addy? Clarabel? Henrietta? And, Percy? And David? Holy shit! You packed up a bunch!
Well, welcome to the club.
Thanks, Thomas. Glad you're all right.
Well, we're glad you're all right when you guys came back. All right, we should probably set up base.
All right, let's do it. All right, ladies and gentlemen. So I think we should all tell each other stories about what happened to all of us during the eclipse. So would any of you like to go first?
I'll go first, Donald.
Alright, Doc. Tell us.
Well, you see, I just dropped off a goods train at Tidmouth Yards, and I decided to have a rest at Tidmouth Sheds. And when the eclipse came, I thought that it came early. However, as I looked at it, I began to feel sharp pain, and that's when I suddenly got infected. And not long after that, Harvey came along, and he kept me company for a few days. And earlier today, Gordon had some voice in his head, and Harvey sacrificed his life to prevent Gordon from killing himself.
I am very sorry that it happened to you, Doc.
Aye, me too. And we also saw Batty, but he blew up, and I saw Castle, who is dead at Crosby. Rest in peace, Harvey, Barry, and Castle. You three will be remembered.
Okay, Donald. It's my turn now. I was taking a stone train down my branch line. I didn't pay much attention to the eclipse, as I was too busy and focused on my job. However, as I passed by Hackerback, I saw people and Daisy getting infected. Not to risk any chances, I made my way towards the quarry to escape this eclipse from hell.
Oh my god. Oh, that was close. I do hope all my friends are okay.
Percy? Mavis? Thomas? I'm glad you're right, best friend.
Glad you're right too, Thomas.
And Mavis? You all right?
Yeah, I'm a little infected, but still the same Corey Diesel.
Oh, I see.
Well, me and Percy were shunting some trucks and filling up with stone when the eclipse occurred. We saw some workmen getting infected, and as well as I did. And my crew is about to come on board, but I feel like my engine is a little dry.
Oh! Ow! Oh! My skirt! Ow!
Oh, shit! Maybe the fuel tankers went dry! I think she's gonna blow!
Oh, crap. This is not looking good! Oh, crap. Yow! Percy! We need to get out of here!
Just run, Thomas! I'll find someone to hide!
Okay! Oh man, I do hope Percy's okay. Oh man, I hope he makes it out alive. I also do hope Toby, Annie, and Clara are alright as well. And even my girlfriend Rosie. After a few hours of calming down after what happened, I made my way down back my branch line where I saw Daisy. She got infected by the eclipse, but I was too sad to notice. When I arrived at Ellsbridge, I saw James. Together, he and I made my way up to Kildane. However, as you see, Donald, it did not go so well.
Alright, it's my turn now. I was chatting with Annie, Clarabelle, and Henrietta, and Sir Topham Hatt getting ready for the party when the eclipse occurred. However, when it came already, I didn't want anyone to die, so I warned everyone to get on board, and I coupled up to Annie and Clebo and Henrietta, and I raced to Knapford. I arrived at the transit hub, where I picked up more people, and yelling at them that we need to get it out of this island, and this is an emergency. I stopped at the bus shed, and what I saw was horrifying. Birdie was infected and dead from the eclipse, so I paid my respects to him before I left. I soon arrived at Dryo, where I saw Harold, who was also infected and had died from crashing into the ground. His pilot and co-pilot were also dead. So I paid my respects to them as well. As I passed by Walsworth, I saw Oliver and Toe picking up some workmen. I yelled at them to keep going. Keep going, Oliver! What the? Toby, what are you doing? As I was passing by Marin, I saw Boko, who was already infected by the eclipse. He turned into a monster and started chasing me!
might be the end of us.
Goodbye, world.
Did I hear that somebody needs my assistance? Listen here, you big green monster! You lend one tentacle of my friend, then you earned yourself a one-way ticket to hell! You mess with Toby and my coaches, then you mess with me! Do you wanna mess with me? Do ya? Do ya? Do ya? Oh hell yeah, that's right! Run away, you coward! Are you alright, guys? Yep, I sure am, Thomas! Thanks for saving us! No problem, Toby! I'll get you out of here in no time! Alright!
Alright, I'll go next. After Mavis died and exploded, I made my way up to Farquhar as well. I arrived at the Farquhar Goods Depot when some dust got into my eyes, and it was rock dust. So, my female driver named Maya constructed some goggles to protect my eyes from dust. When everything was ready, I puffed away to find some survivors down the line. I soon saw Daisy in her shed. She was infected by the eclipse, but I was glad enough that she's alright. She told me what happened to her, and I felt really bad for her. So I got her out of the sheds, and we made our way towards Maithwaite. We spend the night there, and we're gonna look for some survivors tomorrow. And we also got a call from a signalman about Bruce. Apparently he died while trying to escape.
And yeah, that was what happened to us. But I hate to break the moment, we saw an engine shoot past. We saw Eagle with a passenger train heading down the opposite way. We didn't know where he was going. So Neville told us to stay here, and he'll go check the loop line to see if he's okay. However, as he did find Eagle at the bridge, but he crashed into the lake and drowned. And he saw that his tenor was shredded by one of the coaches.
Interesting story, lads. So good, what happened to you?
Well, you see, Donald, I was arriving at Wellsworth with the express. As I was waiting for the passengers to board, I saw Derek pass by me heading towards the docks. However, I think I heard something. Must have been Edward with Douglas. They were doing something.
Nani? What did he do?
You don't want to know, because it scarred me for life.
Edward? What are you doing with Dougie?
What should I tell you?
Well, you told me you were at the harbor when the eclipse occurred.
Really? I thought you said you were calling.
You lied to us, didn't ya?
For shame, Edward, for shame! Tell us what Douglas is, you son of a bucka!
Yeah. Alright! I will fucking tell you!
Whoa, okay. Sorry about that. Anyway, I was at Wellsworth when Douglas arrived with the goods train.
Hello, Edward.
Hey, Douglas.
Any way of taking care of Billy Ben?
Yes, I have.
Good.
However, when the eclipse came, we were very surprised and saw people getting infected. And not long after that, we saw an infected Henry shoot past. Oh, crap. My kids! Douglas and towards the docks!
Edward, what about you? Just do it! Alright, okay, I'm out of here! Edward! You son of a bitch! What were you thinking?
Yeah, because of you, Douglas could be dead!
Alright, that's it. I'm getting the fuck out of here. Edward! Come back!
Well, it's been a few hours, but Donald, do you think you're a little hard on Edward?
Yeah, I think I've been, Doug.
I'm sorry, I just really hope Dougie is okay.
Don't worry, Donald. I'm sure you can find him.
We gotta think of a plan.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I have an important plan for today.
Stop!
Oliver, to head down the Brandon Branch and see if Boogie is there.
All right, Donald. Sounds like a good plan.
Well, Doc and Daisy, I think you two might have to stay here because your mutations look hideous.
Well, okay. We both understand already.
Well, yeah, I can't go either because my cowcatcher needs to be mended after that accident.
It's alright, Toby. So, I'm thinking Morley, Neville, Thomas, and Percy, you go search down the main line and hopefully you four can find Rebecca and Rosie.
Yeah, good idea. Because I really hope my girlfriend is okay.
Yeah, I agree with my son, Thomas. I also really wanted to find my golden queen, but good luck finding them.
Yeah, well, good said.
And also, I had to interrupt.
Toby, what is it?
To Edward's voice when he's telling the truth, his voice sounded demonic.
Yeah, whatever this thing is, it's not Edward.
Yeah, he sounded possessed or something. Not feeling the Great Western way at all.
Oh yeah, but also, you mentioned something about Nia.
Nia? Wait, Nia, what's up? We hope Edward's girlfriend is okay.
Yeah, I think we needed Nia's help to help out with Edward, because he's been acting strange and I should be really worried about him.
Yeah, and I also do hope that Derek's alright.
I feel the same way.
Well, I call this missing. Operation! Don't bring the book! So, that's sorted out good?
Yup, I'm sorted out. So, the instructions. I'll be pulling two more suited coaches with a bunch of men and women with armed weapons in case if we're attacked. And also, Donald, you'll be right behind. And Oliver, you will be right behind Donald with a flatbed in case we find Trevor, and with a van, a bunch of guns and weapons, with Toad right behind. And, Grace, Pearl, and Maya will be on board, as well as Coco, Bella, Sandy, and even Sir Tom the Hat will come along.
Alright! Let's sort it out!
Yeah, I agree with Donald and Gordon. They noticed it all my engines. We're turning this party into an awesome war zone. So yeah, I've been writing this Operation Storm Random Doc's plan out on a piece of paper with Jack, Coco, and the rest. So you know what I say? Thanks for letting me join the battle board.
No problem.
And to all the lads who are doing this plan, good luck.
And you know what I say? You're saving Toby from the story, Thomas. You are definitely a great hero, my son.
Well, thanks, Gordon. Well, good luck.
We'll be on our way in no time.
Well, here we go.
It's time for the moment you've been waiting for.
System check. Stand by for system check.
Operation Starfighter Ghost is in takeoff position.
The one unit coaches and the flatbed van are a go.
All of our boiler pressures is a go. All of our weapons is now online. All of our NAG levels ready for takeoff. All people in the warning suit coaches are now armed. All of our lamp irons are a go.
The security systems at Brandon are now online.
The couplings to the consists are now in place.
All systems green for two groups. Awaiting your command for Gordon, Donald, and Oliver.
What's who's up?
Yeah, I understand, Gordon.
So, how'd you survive?
Well, I was sleeping when the Eclipse arrived.
I woke up, and when Jem arrived, he claimed that he hasn't been able to sleep, and he decided to take me out to marvel at the eclipse. Only then I realized that it arrived. I had stopped and I heard a horn. Then, to my horror, I saw the thing clattering slowly past me. I was out of water, and I can't build any steam.
Well, yeah, being out of water sucks.
Yeah, totally. But, what are you, Donald and Oliver, doing?
Well, we're going to Stormbrand of the Ducks to find Dougie.
Yeah, I agree with Donald. We're trying to work together as a team while the rest of our group goes into the main line to find Rosie and Rebecca. Alright. Good luck!
Thank you.
Alright then! Charge!
Alright! Let's do it!
Yeehaw!
Not one of you's gonna survive, kid!
Alright then! Now where is Dookie? It could be anywhere!
Close again. But who pushed the thing away from me? Maybe I should go check further to see if Billy been ill. Oh my god!
Ah, poor Bill, Ben, and even Fergus.
Oh man, this must have been the work of the thing.
Oh man, where is Dougie? He's gonna be here somewhere.
Wait, is that?
Donnie! Donnie!
Oh my god! Donnie!
I risked my life as an adventurer to find you. How did you do that?
Well, you see, we have gathered up a bunch of groups, and we have formed a team together to find you.
Hey, not a sick one? Glad to see you alive.
Mission accomplished.
Hey, I wonder where Oliver is.
Wait, lads, you hear him?
Yeah, I think so, Donny.
Oliver, what's going on?
Houston, we have a problem!
What? You were totally at the entrance of Broadup?
Right! Gwen, me and Toad were not the only ones. Someone thing was on our tail. Looked like Harvey, but he's a monster, but we're not ready to die, but it's getting bad. Oh, God! Seems like the battle is getting intense. But where's the group? Oh, wait! Here they come!
Oh man! Is everyone okay?
Yeah, where are I going? Hey, yeah. That was a close call. I can't even believe that Harvey had killed Tolt. I mean, yeah, this would have been worse if we would have been dead. Aye, yeah, but at least we are back together.
Alright, Donnie, is anyone here?
Aye.
They sure are, Dougie.
Thomas, Percy, Neville, Molly already found Rosie and Rebecca. Seems like they already have a reunion. Hey, ever since Thomas and Rosie, Gunn and Rebecca love each other, I guess I could say that. But, Dougie, did you see anyone else at the docks? Hey, we sure did. I found Derek, but he's injured. Oh, so Derek, could you please tell us about what happened to you during the eclipse and how did you get injured?
Well, it's a long story, Donald and Douglas. I was taking a goods train to the docks when the eclipse struck. I passed by Gordon at Wellsworth before everything went to chaos. And as I saw people at Sodory getting infected, I made my way towards the docks to escape this eclipse from hell. However, yeah, I saw Salty, Cranky, and Porter, and they're all alive. They told me that, when I saw Bill and Ben's remains, I screamed in horror, and also paid my respects to them, and even Fergus. Well, yeah, that was until the thing came out and tried to kill all of us. Although Porter was infected by the eclipse, but the thing eventually used his tendrils and killed him. The thing was one of my best friends, Boko. I was traumatized. Some gunmen tried to shoot down the thing, but they accidentally hit Cranky and he fell on Salty. And Salty blew up, as well as Cranky. And I tried to get away from the thing, but he eventually tore half of my face until I blacked out. But that was until someone saved me. Douglas was there. Douglas told me that he was taking a goods train and stopped at Wellsworth and was talking to Edward when the eclipse struck. And yeah, he also told me that Henry had shot past. He said that Trixie and Crimson were good friends with Hunter. Yeah. So, do you have any medical supplies?
Jack has found some medical supplies from a nearby hospital.
Oh, thanks. But it seems like that was until you two reunite together, but do you think that's the only mission done?
Maybe, but there's still part of the mission need to be done. So, I guess, mission accomplished, brother! Victory! Alright. Well, back together again, Donnie. Hey, yeah. Glad to be back together. Golden, what about you and Rebecca?
Yeah, we sure are, Donald and Douglas.
Yeah, I agree with Gordon. I'm really glad to see my husband again.
Yeah, I love you, Rebecca.
I love you too, Gordon.
Hey, but you know what I say? Couples love and brotherly love? It's like the NWO's a family. Hey, Donnie? Yeah, definitely. Ever since we are brothers, we will never be apart again. Hell yeah.
Well, yeah. I'm feeling better when I'm bandaged.
Hey, glad you're feeling all right, Derek.
Thanks, Douglas. And, I know Duncan is also Scottish.
Hey, we hope he's alive as well. Wait, Donnie, you heard that whistle? Hey, sounds like Edward. What is he doing here?
What the hell? That's weird. I wonder where Edward is going, and what is that noise? Maybe I should follow him.
Did anybody hear that? Hi, Donnie. I think I hear some weird noise in Edward's firebox, and I wonder where Oliver is going.
Yeah, I do hope he's okay, guys.
Yeah, if not, I guess we'll go find him.
Oh,
Dougie, I think we're being watched. I think I can see Bunker in the distance, but... Oh, Burr, it's really cold. Yeah, but we better not make a move. Okay, seems like that was close. Seems like Bunker reversed the other way into the snow. Hey, let's just hope Heart of It doesn't find us. Oh, crap. I think he found us. Do it, lads! I'm holding on! Come on, then! Bring it on, you crazy monster! Whoa! Ed! Is that whistle?
Wait! Stop it! I can't hear! Get out of there! Oh crap! It's motocross in the army! Drop that!
How's Henry and his crew? Hunter told me that Trixie and Crimson are alright, but he is checking over their wounds, and he is giving them some medical supplies. And Henry is not badly damaged, but he had a bunch of bruises and a bunch of horrible scars.
So, Henry, what happened to you during the eclipse, and how did you get infected?
Well, it's kind of a short story, Gordon. I was pulling a goods train to Krobin's Gate to get ready for the Valentine's party that Sir Topper Hat has assigned for when the eclipse comes. However, when it came, I realized that something was not right. And as I began to feel sharp pain, those tendril fan blade things covered my eyes and mouth before I could do anything. I was fully sentient the whole time. I wasn't even crying, but I was literally screaming, and I was trying to shout at you and Donald to distract Boca, but I could still hear what Trixie Crimson told me. Also, I killed Mary. Well, here I am now. Glad I got these things off, but still got a bunch of cuts and scars. And I really hope Emily is okay.
Do you think Emily will be alright, Henry?
I am not sure, Rebecca.
I got a quick question, Henry. Do you think Wellskull could have predicted your mutation?
That is a difficult question, Donald. Let me see. I used a hopper for my old special Wellskull when I was an R3 prototype. The answer is no.
Oh, I see, Henry. That sounds like a difficult question to ask.
Yeah, it could be.
Hey, Donald, Douglas, I got some bad news from Duke's driver.
Apparently,
after Duke found Sir Handel, Peter, Sam, and Freddy, Peter, Sam, and Freddy are going to split up with Duke and Sir Handel to find any more survivors while Duke and Sir Handel wait for them. However,
Peter Sam was the only one returned, and Freddy did not. Peter Sam told Duke and Sirhanel that Reneas was about to kill them, and Freddy sacrificed his life by blowing himself up. And as they made their way back to Corbin's Gate, they found Mighty Mac, and they were both mutated and put out of their misery. And as they rounded the curve, they found Bertram. Duke said that his brother's death will never suit his grace. Seems like they lost luck finding his brother. But however, as they arrived back at Crovitz Gate at their base, they saw Duncan. Duncan told them that he was at the Bluebell branch line when the eclipse struck. He said that he passed by Rusty and heard the crash behind him. Duncan could only assume he was dead.
Ugh, goddammit. Seems like we lost more navigate engines. They can't believe that we lost Bertram.
But we got some good news.
What's the good news, Jack?
Well, I got a call from Hank and Timothy's crew. Apparently, they were at Knapford Harbor preparing some evacuation efforts onto some ships away from Sodor onto Britain and to other countries. So apparently, some people are climbing off aboard some coaches from Hank and Timothy's train, and they're going to load on the ships. And there are other evacuation trains from some mainland engines. And they also told us that they're not alone.
Billy and Charlie were hiding in Knapford sheds with Dudley, along with Ashton and Croven.
And they also told us that on day two, before we met up with the group, 16 and Wilbur were trying to escape to the mainland to be heroes, but they never did come back.
Oh, I guess it's good to know that the others are alright, and even our old friends, 19462 and 87546. So Gwen, did you get a call from anyone else?
Oh yeah, I got a call from Leonard, Stephanie, Nia, Splatter, and Dodge. They were hiding in the yard at Kirk Ronan.
Alright, good.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so I have an important plan for our next battle.
So,
the plan is me, Doogie, Henry, Gwen, Doug, Thomas, Percy, and Toby will head down all the way down the main line to kill the thing and save Edward. And we also got all of our walkie-talkies to communicate with the others if we need backup. So, Derek, you will be watching Annie, Claribel, Henrietta, and Daisy, along with Rebecca and Rosie. Alright?
Alright, I'm coming with you, Donald.
Yeah, I already understand.
Alright, Donald, you can count on me. Glad we have enough walkie-talkies to communicate with the others.
Yeah, because if anything goes wrong in this battle, we need backup.
Yeah, I agree with you, Goon. But we gotta prepare lamps for our next stage.
Donald, where are we going?
Well, we're heading to Crunk Abbey. Hopefully we can find Oliver there. And we're gonna have a stop there before the final fight.
Right, that'll be good. Well, I'm glad Henry is okay.
Yeah, but our big black five had a black eye and some scars and a bruise.
Yeah, at least he's alive though.
Whoa, wait, did you smell something?
Yeah, smells really nasty. Smells like blood.
Yeah, it might be James's corpse, Donald. If he's still dead, I don't know. Or it could be something else.
Yeah, Gordon. We probably might have to find the source of the smell. I mean, I hope it's gotta be something.
Yeah. What could it be right there?
The hell? Is that Oliver?
Oh shit! We lost him!
Oliver! No!
What the hell?
thought you're dead!
Yeah, what Donald said. I thought you blew up.
So, Jake, what happened to you during the eclipse?
Okay, guys, it's kind of a long story. I was getting ready to pull a local train down to Provincegate for the party when the eclipse struck. So I was waiting patiently at Napford. When the eclipse came, I realized something was suspicious. And later on, people started to get infected. I realized that I wasn't coupled to the coaches, so I just sped off. And I saw Harvey and Leonard at the harbor. And I didn't stop until I got to Ellsbridge. Oliver and Toad were hiding in the goods shed. And many minutes later, Thomas arrived at Ellsbridge. He told me everything about what happened to him. Well, Henry wasn't the only runaway I saw. Albert was also one of them. He was screaming in pain, but his screams were muffled, and his eyes were, like, extended. So, me and Thomas went to kill them together. However, the thing went after us and was sent down the Pure God Red Branch line. After arriving at Kildane, I really wanted to look for Gorn and Douglas. I also felt really bad for Henry, because he was also one of my best friends, and he didn't deserve a fate like that. But I realized my boiler ran dry. I begged Todd and Paul to help me, and I didn't want to die. But the two morons ran! So me and Thomas tried to think of a plan until Donald came in. I tried to shout at all of you to run until the pain is getting badder, and that's when everything went black. Well, before I continue, have you seen my yellow sunshine, Molly?
Yes. She's at Wellsworth with Neville, Rosie, Daisy, Derek, and the others at Wellsworth.
Alright, good. I just want to see my yellow sunshine again. But do you want to know why Oliver is dead?
Yes, I do, Jake. I want to know how he died.
Yeah. I just really wanted to know. Because I saved him from scrap all those years ago. Until now.
I understand how it feels, Donald and Douglas. Well, as I woke, Edward stood in front of me, menacingly.
Oh, my head. Where am I? Ah!
Yeah! Edward? What's going on?
Oh, there you are, James. You're awake.
Why are you standing there, menacingly?
Asking me why I'm standing here? I have a grand plan. You are important to the safety of the destruction of Sodor, James.
What do you mean by that, Edward? Let me go!
Relax, James. I'm not gonna hurt you. I want you to kill all the engines in the group, like Donald and the rest. And I hear that they're gonna go looking for Oliver.
What? Edward, what is wrong with you?
Nothing much, my friend. I am just like Boko.
Holy shit! This scared the crap out of me! Oh man, where are my friends? And even my brother Eagle? And my girlfriend Molly? I hope they're okay.
Well, yeah, he was possessed or something. But I'm glad you guys are here.
I know, James. Toad was also dead. No, Oliver. And I'm glad you're back from the dead.
Yeah, you have your father's eyes.
Thanks, Gordon.
Doc, I'm so sorry. Oliver and Toad are gone. Even Arthur.
No, that's it. I had enough.
Doc, why are you mad all of a sudden?
It's
guys, don't you think a little hard on him?
I'm not sure, Gordon, but he is definitely heartbroken. I do hope he's alright.
Yeah, if not, then I guess we'll go find him.
Maybe we were hard on him. I'll check the line to see if anyone else is there.
Should someone go with Thomas?
I'll go. Stay here, everyone. I'll be back.
Well, I'm sorry about Duck, but have any of you seen Eagle?
So, who's going to tell him?
What? Tell me what? Please, what are you talking about? What happened to Ego? Please!
James, I'm so sorry. Eagle, your brother is gone.
What? What? No. Dude, you're lying!
It's true. Neville found his remains at the lake near the loop line.
No! Eagle! God damn it! Why him?
James, relax. He's in a better place now. Me and Gordon are here with you. And Donald and Douglas are here with you as well. Let's just set up camp here and get ready for the final battle. And I'll take some time to calm you down. Okay?
Okay, Henry. Thank you.
James? Are you feeling any better?
Yes, I am, Henry. I already got my lamp set up, and Hunter already cleaned the blood off of my face. But thanks for comforting me. You and Gordon have been my best friends on the railway. Ever since we became streamers.
Yeah, I understand, James. We'll always be here for you no matter what, okay?
I know.
Gordon, how is James doing right now?
He's feeling better right now. Henry is already helping him recover, but Henry will be heartbroken if he finds out about his wife, Emily.
Hey. It would be very sad to see that he lost his Emerald Angel.
Yeah. How's Dilly right now?
She's doing pretty fine. Jack is feeding her some bread right now. Hey, Dilly is part of our family ever since we are brothers of the Little Western.
Thomas and Toby have been gone for a while. Should we go check on them? Oh well, speak of the devil.
What's up, y'all? Look who we found!
Spencer?
Hello, everyone. It's been a while, hasn't it?
Yeah, sure has been, my dear cousin. Where have you been, Spencer?
Well, it's kind of a short story. Well, apparently, one of the Eclipse even reached Barrow, so I've been taken out with evacuation efforts. And while I was resting, I decided to go venture onto Sodor, and I had to go for help. Once I crossed the bridge, I found a few things that were worse off here. I was attacked by Vickerstown by Stanley, who had already been taken over by the Eclipse, and I found Jinted Pug, gutted. And I began to run, and as I ran, I found Reginald, or Big City Engine. He was infected and dead, and before I reached Crovin's Gate, and when I passed by Balaru, I saw Spam Cap, but he was infected as well. And, I stopped by Kelso Road, where I found Oldslow Coach. And, I heard Duck heading down the Kirkrod and Branch line. And, that's when Thomas and Toby found me. But, however, before he arrived at Kronk, we found Neil,
He had a broken and detached jaw and was put out of his misery. And, yeah, I also got a call from Mickey and Joey from the Sodor Fire Department and the Police Department that there are some other evacuation efforts at Natford Harbor.
Oh, I guess it's good to know that the others are alright, except for the ones that died.
Oh yeah, I did mention some of our other friends from the LNER. Oh yeah, Gwen, I did mention that too. I mentioned about Flying Scotsman, Reno, and Flying Thistle, but those three are on the mainland, so they're probably safe. Yeah, I was thinking about them too, my dear cousin. Even my two brothers.
Right. So you and Gorin are talking about the other two remaining A3s of the LNER.
Yes, I am, Thomas.
Right. So, me and the group will kill the thief.
So,
is everyone with me? Yes, I am, Donnie.
I am with you, Donald. I am with you as well.
Yeah, let's do this, boys.
Yep. You can count on me.
You can count on me as well.
Oh, yeah. I rescued Scruffy, Rickety, Fred, and Sebastian from the thing. They told me that they had been kidnapped in Kirk Ronan. Well, I'm glad you saved them, Spencer. You're definitely the fastest A4 up so far. I sure am, Gordon. Well, I'm gonna start evacuating the town for the battle. You boys ready? We are ready. All right. Now let's get to work to save our home.
Oh man, I made it to Kirk Ronan Yards on my own. And because of it, I had a breakdown about Oliver's death. But what should I do to kill that monster? There's gotta be a way to save my home. Fuel tankers and gunpowder vans? These seem perfect! You may be gone, Oliver.
But it's all Bucko's fault! And I'm gonna kill him right now!
Donald? Douglas? Forgive me for doing this.
Alright then! Now let's go and avenge my fallen friend!
Alright lads, so we're getting ready for the next battle. Golden, where is Spencer right now?
He's evacuating the town right now. He'll be alright.
Alright, that's good, Golden.
Whoa! Everyone, halt! Is that Murdoch?
Yes, Golden. I saw his dead corpse days ago.
Rest in peace, Murdoch. You will be remembered as one of our favorite Mahdi agents.
Seems like he didn't have a fighting chance. Aye, Donnie. We will definitely miss one of our strong fellows here.
Well, he and I have been forest buddies for a long time.
Indeed, Henry, my man. We will definitely miss our strong engine.
Well, we're no problem scared anymore. But we failed to find Murdoch.
Yeah. I really pray to God that Emily made it out of her place alive. I just hope she's alive still.
Calm down, Henry. I'm sure we can find your wife somewhere.
You're probably right, James.
Alright, everyone. We're near Castle Road. Let's just stop here.
Wait! Is that Emily?
Emily? Are you okay?
Oh my god!
No. No. She can't be dead. No. No. No!
Oh man, Henry. I'm sorry. We're too late.
Your Emerald Angel is already gone.
Oh come on, Gordon and Douglas! It's Elwood and Bucko's fault for her death! It's all their faults!
Don't worry, Emily. I'll avenge you. I promise it from the bottom of my heart.
could agree with you, Henry. I also wanted to avenge my brother, Eagle.
All right, James. Let's get our revenge.
Good to see you guys. I've been expecting you.
You have?
I have. I've been expecting you at Kongami the whole time. But I want you to join us on our side.
Oh, hell no. You messed up now, Eddie. Ye just messed with the wrong twins! Golden, Henry, Thief, get that thing!
We'll take care of this, Donald! And you! Take this!
Well, try me, Donald and Douglas.
Scotland! Forever!
Come on, Dan Boko! Bring it on!
You wanna try and fight me and my son, leaders of the railway? Come on, Dan!
Whoa! I'm the actual head! What are you all doing? What are you trying to kill me?
Duncan! What are you doing here? This is a restricted area!
Yeah! We're in a combat zone!
Come on, Edward! Try not to think I'm controlling you!
I tried, Donald! But I couldn't do it!
Well, try on the lad!
What? Wait, is that Doug? I think so, Edward. Hey, what is he doing?
Everybody! Move! Move!
Stop! What are you doing with these tank guns?
This is the only way to save Sodor, and the gate is deep. Look, I'll be with Oliver, John, Arthur, and Brian.
What? No!
Oh, shit.
You hear it, Doug? Let's go!
Well, I'm getting the hell out of here.
Well, this is the Great Western Way.
Well, the monster is dead.
Yeah, and Doug sacrificed his life to save us all and to be with Oliver, Toad, Arthur and Ryan.
Well, I hope things can't get any worse.
Wait a second! We need to call the others! I think our twins need help with Edward!
Alright, we already killed the thing. Let's call reinforcements and move in!
Well then, let's go, boys!
Wait for us, you three!
Hey, Donald and Douglas! Are you two going down?
What do you not right, buddy? We call the others for help!
Hang on in there, y'all! We are coming in!
And don't forget about me! This is for 16!
Yeah!
Oh, damn! Nice shot, Homer! Thanks, Derek.
You two want me to burn in hell?
Oh, you will never, fucker!
Whoa! Did you alright?
All right, Gordon. He really hit us hard.
But what are you waiting for, Donald Douglas? See Edward by pushing him into the shed.
Don't worry. I got this.
Yeah! Holy shit! What's the name of all of the arms Douglas doing?
What in the name of Luba are you?
Oh my god! What the fuck?
Molly, David, Daisy, let him, Doug, Stephanie, the soul time to explain!
Dougie! Get off of there!
Don't worry, Donny. I'll be out of there no time.
Come on, old friend! Try and fight the Eclipse! I can't! Well, then try harder, lad! I can't! Well, then try harder! I can't! Oh, come on, Doctor! We really want you
back! Hey there. What happened?
You had me possessed by that lump, Edward. So we bound you in the Crowman's Gate Works to set you free.
Oh. Thank you.
Victory.
Oh man, Donny. Quite an adventure, eh? Aye, Dougie. Boy, we almost done like everything. I found you, and we saved Edward and killed Boko and almost everything. I mean, seems like Tobum got that lump out. So, let's just hope Edward recovers.
So, Edward, are you feeling a little better?
I am, Gordon.
So, could you please tell me, how did you get cursed?
Okay, I'll tell you, Gordon. Apparently, on February 11th, I've been taking a post train to the docks, but I have been held back by faulty points. As I was ready to leave, I heard Boko screaming. With all my good intentions, I sprinted towards the sound because I was concerned for my best friend. And the last thing I remembered is seeing a set of shiny new bubbers right in front of me and ripping them clean in half. And when I awoke, I found myself in a white void with a large movie screen-like thing in front of me, playing everything I did. No, the thing inside of me did, from Douglas to you to Oliver. And as I awoke the second time, I was back to reality. But I didn't remember about what happened at all. And yeah, it made me do the things I was never meant to do, and I feel like I'm such an idiot. And, have you seen some of my other best friends? Like, Albert?
Well, I got a call from Billy and Charlie's crew. Apparently they heard an explosion at Tidmouth Harbor. So, the two jokesters went to investigate, and they were really concerned. And however, as they did find the fire, they saw the remains of one furnace engine. Albert was dead.
Oh man, I should have saved him. But any update about Barry?
Yes, I got a call from Dudley's driver. Apparently, Dudley was part of the evacuation efforts at Hanford. And apparently, Timothy Ashton and Crove and told him that Barry was dead because he had exploded. So the four engines paid their respects to him and let him rest in peace in the snow.
I will miss you very much, Barry. You were like a cousin to me after the Second World War.
Yeah, we will miss you as one of our rescue engines, Barry. And my brother did a really good job on a fight at Croven's Gate.
Yeah, we will miss you very much as well. I do wish you were still with us, but time goes on. Yeah, I agree with Ashton. We'll let you rest in peace, Barry.
Oh, wow. I'm really happy that two of our old friends, who are formerly 98462 and 87546, are alright.
Yeah, because me and Ashton have been pals as express engines in the 1920s.
Yeah, I already know that, Gordon. But, has any of you seen Nia? I really wanted to see her. Yeah, she was with us before the fight, Edward.
What? Really, Stephanie? You and Leonard have?
Yes, we do. She is on her way right now. Well, ever since the unfortunate passing of our old friend, Duck, she would be really happy to see you again.
Yeah, that's good. I'm really sorry about Duck.
Oh my god, he really is!
Hell, Dunny, seems like Edward's wife is coming.
Hey, I guess she'll be happy to see him again.
Oh, Duke, this is gonna be such a happy ending. I know, Duncan. Let's see that.
Is it really you, Nia?
Yes, it is, Edward. It's me.
Oh my god. Nia, I'm so glad you're alive, my love.
I'm glad you're alive too as well, Edward. Stephanie and Leonard call me here to see you.
I know that, Nia. But didn't you realize that I was possessed all these days ago?
Yeah, I did. I was really concerned about you. But I got a call from Jack saying that we saved you. I loved you very much.
Me?
Of course, Edward. Even though you lost Albert and Boko, I'm always here for you.
Yeah, I love you too, Nia. I'll always be here for you as well. And your name was really special to me.
Well, we did it. But I think there's still hope.
Yeah, there is, Gwen. I just wanted to tell Dilly something.
Oh, here comes Sir Topham Hatt. He's gonna place your little duckling on your footplate.
Yeah, we wanted to hear what you speak, Donald.
Hey, Dilly. How are you doing, sweetie?
Sir, what should I do?
Just speak to her.
Okay. Dilly, I really wanted to say something. I want you to save our world. Save our home. It was all up to me and my brother. I spoke for God knows how long. Even getting Jack to read the journal. I had taken everything for granted. I want everything back the way it was. I really wanted James to see his brother Eagle again. I also really wanted to Henry to see Emily again.
Donnie, are you crying?
I am kinda crying a little, Dougie. Dilly, I'm begging you, and I'm pleading with you. And promise me if you fix this and I take you along with us.
Wait, Dougie? Dilly? Is that Lady?
Hi, guys.
Lady, I'm so glad you're okay. Me and Rosie miss you a lot through these past few years.
I miss you a lot as well, Thomas. I'm glad that you and Rosie went through that adventure with the twins.
Hey, Lady, could you reset the world for us? I don't want to be possessed again.
Yeah, I agree with Edward. I just want to have a fun Valentine's party. Of course, Edward and Nia. Y'all ready?
Oh my god!
Donnie! It's a flash of light! It is magic indeed. Alright, everyone. Are you ready to assert the world?
Yeah, we're ready.
Huh? Wait, did the void actually... Oh my god! Clay! Jack! What's up, my man? Oh my god, I'm so glad you're back! And I'm glad I'm back alive as well.
Oh my god! I think I actually did it! Well, I'm such a hero, indeed!
Oh, hey there, Donald. I think you missed the eclipse.
Well, I definitely did, Ranaez. You ready for the party?
Yep. I'll see you there.
See you there, Ranaez.
Oh, man, Donnie. I'm having a blast.
Hi, Dougie. I am really a hero. Definitely save a world.
Indeed you did, Donald. And I'm really proud of all of you.
Well, Duke, big cheers to the Scottish twin.
Yeah. Indeed, Scarlowy. I'm so glad you're alive.
Yeah, back from the dead, indeed.
Well, Oliver, another day alive in the Little West, dude.
Yep. Big cheers to the Scottish twins, dude.
Well, Emily, my love, I am so happy that I have you back.
I'm happy to be with you as well, Henry. I love you very much. I also don't want to lose you.
But I don't want to lose you either.
I can understand you two. I am glad I'm back from the dead as well.
Same here, bear. Mighty NF is back on the rails today.
Well, I could talk about my survival and the other survival of the eclipse as a scary story.
What do you mean by that, Henry?
Well, could you explain that?
Well, it's quite common for myself as a black guy to tell a scary story about an apocalyptic survival.
Okay, that would be weird, Henry. Although there have been many ghost stories about famous incidents here in the island of the old times in the UK.
Well, yeah. I already know that, Murdoch.
It could be true, Murdoch. But you and Henry have been forest buddies for a long time.
Oh, yeah. Although I mostly need to do a piece of quiet, I'm just really having a blast.
Looks like the eclipse passed. Hey, so you know what that means?
Well, Donald and Douglas, I am really proud of the both of you. Even the rest of us. And you know what I say? You two are heroes of the island!
Well, yeah. The light was amazing. We hadn't felt sunlight in our long time, and it felt wonderful. And it was back to work. Well, we were just leaving Brenna right now, and Clay and Louie are gonna go back for dinner, and I am with Donald, as well as Coco. I am pretty happy. Well, I guess this is where our story ends. I'm out of journal pages, basically, and I never want to think about this nonsense ever again. Maybe aside from Coco, I am AO, but it's over. But I guess now it's just about to work. So long!
Rising. every day by myself, I'm breaking down. I don't want.